Hi Francesca, this is the sample from the Department of Oncological and Degenerative Spine Surgery of the Rizzoli Orthopedic Institute.
Thank you, Maria. It's the vertebra bone marrow clot. Let's go. We are directly culturing vertebra bone marrow clot as it is. Let's check the osteogenic potential and the mesenchymal stem cell phenotype. Oh, it's wonderful! How many cells? Also results on differentiation, growth kinetic, viability, phenotype and gene expression profile are very impressive. The cellular source inside the clotted vertebra bone marrow show the best biological property. The use of vertebra bone marrow eliminates the need to concentrate and or purify bone marrow, and also represent a biological scaffold and a powerful source of mesenchymal stem cell for patients undergoing spinal surgery. This property could be very useful to improve spinal fusion rate in patients with degenerative spine disease. So, in collaboration with the spine surgeon, we started a pilot clinical study and the first 7 patients have been treated. Vertebra bone marrow harvested during the preparation of the site for the pedicle screen session and clotting during the progress of surgical procedure is directly introduced in the fusion site. Promising results concerning pain reduction were obtained, and we are now planning a larger clinical trial to confirm the hospital data also in terms of fusion rate. And I would like to thank the complex structure of surgical site technology where I both work and the Department of Oncologic and Degenerative Spine Disease.
Oh, hello. Please, be my guest. This is Marco Viganò from the Galeazzi Orthopedic Institute. I was working with MicroFrat. Have you ever heard of it? It is a convenient way to apply the potential of adipose tissue in degenerative disease. Did you ever think about what's the difference between lipoaspirate and MicroFrat? Well, you can tell it by yourself. You know, lipoaspirate is very reddish and the tissue is more difficult to inject, while MicroFrat is clear yellow and the clusters of the tissue are smaller and easier to inject. But of course, science is not about looking about colors, it's about measurements and math, and I prepared some graph for you, if you may enjoy it. You see, erythrocytes and lymphocytes are pretty reduced in MicroFrat compared to lipoaspirate, but the stromal cells, MSCs, pericytes and endothelial cells are maintained between the two tissues before and after processing. In addition, the niche, stromal niche, is maintained, as you can see from IgE staining. We have the same tissue architecture, but less red blood cells in MicroFrat compared to LA. And also, we have a reduction in the dimension of the vessels. Of course, you know, once injected in your knee, they don't need vessels anymore. But these are just shallow analyses. We have gone deeper, like we have put the tissue in culture for 24 hours, and then we analyzed the conditioned medium. Here, I have some serum-free medium. And if we wait for 24 hours, we can analyze the conditioned medium and the secretome produced by the tissue. You know, the paracrine action is very important for the action of MicroFrat. Fortunately, I prepared some graph just to avoid you waiting for 24 hours. And we see that the extracellular vesicles are similar in terms of dimension and quantity in the two tissues, and the microRNA correlate very well, except for microRNAs that are related to blood, red RBC and plasma, which are quite reduced in microcurrent. Of course, among these, we have a lot of chondroprotective mRNA. So it is very important when you deal with osteoarthritis. We also check the protein content, and you can see that both tissue cluster very well depending on the removal of blood elements such as hemoglobin and acute phase proteins, so inflammatory elements that are reduced in microfat, and this is very important. Same could be said for tissue proteomics. So that's all. Thank you for watching the video, and now you know why you should microfragment your adipose tissue before injecting that in your knee. Bye.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for giving me the opportunity to show our project that is focused on the comparison of the anti-inflammatory and regenerative potential of two different type of mesenchymal stem cells using a microfluidic arthritic joint model. I'm Daniele D'Arrigo, and I'm a PhD student at the University of Milano Bicocca, but I'm working at the Regional Hospital of Lugano in Switzerland. For this project, we design this five-channel microfluidic model. You can see here the dimension. And within this microfluidic model, the first aim of our project is to develop a model of arthritic joint on a chip using fibroblasts from the synovial membrane in this channel, chondrocytes in this channel, and the synovial fluid in this channel. This model has been also used to simulate an intra-articular injection of mesenchymal stem cells that are resuspended in synovial fluid and injected in the central channel. And now let's see how we can inject our cells in our model. For example, as I showed before, the synovial fibroblasts are isolated from the synovial membrane of arthritic patients and are resuspended in a fibrin gel and injected in this channel. From the same patient, we also isolate chondrocytes and we resuspend in a hyaluronic acid-based hydrogel, and we inject in this other channel. And with this microfluidic approach, we were able to compartmentalize the cells in their respective hydrogel, and also provide the cells to culture the cells in a 3D microenvironment. And after the injection of the two cells, we also add synovial fluid in the central channel, and we show that it has a deleterious effect on the articular cells cultured in our device. And finally, from four donors, we isolated bone marrow and adipose tissue derived mesenchymal stem cells that were resuspended in synovial fluid and injected in the central channel. And we were able to collect the medium from our device to quantify the cytokines and before and after the MSCs injection and compare the two MSCs types. This model will be also used in future to compare the effectiveness of other MSCs derived products such as secretome and extracellular vesicles. So this is our platform and our project. Thank you for your attention.